But first this morning, the Prime Minister has met with editors and executives from Rupert Murdoch's Australian newspapers. The meeting follows the phone hacking scandal in the UK, which refuses to go away. Just as that meeting was taking place, police in Britain were making another high-profile arrest. And joining us now with all the details from our bureau in Canberra is our political reporter Amanda Hart. Good morning, Amanda. What exactly was on the PM's agenda last night?
Well, Tash, the Prime Minister had told us that she wanted to discuss her vision for the future and her government's reform agenda, but really she'd be asking questions of news management about what she calls is bias in the papers against her government. Now, tensions between the two have been simmering for a number of months now. It was really brought to a head by the UK phone hacking scandal, although it should be noted there is no suggestion that News Limited here has done any such thing. Now, the Prime Minister also said that News Limited had some tough questions to answer, but she wouldn't really comment at all about how the meeting went. Let's have a listen.
Prime Minister, what have you had to say to the editors?
Oh, we've had a chat. Thanks very much.
Now, the editor of Melbourne's Herald Sun newspaper wasn't at the meeting last night, but said meetings such as this between prime ministers and opposition leaders and newspaper management are quite common. So let's have a listen to his reaction to it now and from the opposition.
In the case of the prime ministers, they might raise some issues and some things that they would like to bring to the forefront of our thinking. I'm sure that Julia did that yesterday.
When you start complaining about the media, I think you've lost the plot. I really do.
And Amanda, what's the latest on the UK phone hacking scandal? I understand there have been some new developments.
Tash, another former News of the World executive was arrested and questioned by police overnight over more phone hacking allegations. Now, it's believed to be 71-year-old Stuart Cutner. Now, he left his role as managing editor of the paper 2 years ago. He's the 11th person to be arrested over this scandal. Now, this comes as the comedian who threw a foam pie at Rupert Murdoch during the parliamentary hearing was sentenced to 6 weeks jail, although that has been cut down to 3 weeks. That's the only time that he will serve. Now, the judge had said that the hearing had been conducted with dignity until he threw the foam pie at Mr. Murdoch. Now, the comedian, who is also known as Johnny Marbles, will or has already lodged an appeal.
Amanda Hart, thank you for updating us this morning.